Hi, this is Lynn from wisconsingarden.com, and it's over 60 degrees. Yes, in March, it is over 60 degrees. So we are taking full advantage of this, and we are going to be trimming our old peach trees. Well, eventually we'll trim all of our peach trees, but these two trees, this one and the one behind me, are probably, we've had them for 4 or 5 years now. And the first year we got just a few peaches on them, and then the next year we got 10 times that many, and then the following year we had scads. Then we had a drought year, and last year we had nothing, no blossoms, nothing. We think they were just really, really tired. And so what we're doing with these big ones is we're going to rejuvenate them by really cutting them back. But any tree that you're trimming, you want to make sure that any fruit tree you're trimming, you want to make sure to do it systematically so that you don't get overburdened or confused as to what you're doing. So first I'm going to go through and I'm going to take out any branches that are growing downward. Downward is not good. Okay, so this whole branch will come off. Next I'm going to be trimming anything that is going upward, vertical, like this one and this one. Vertical is not good. We're looking for a perfect would be 30 to 45 degree angle is the best. And then thirdly, I'm going to be taking out anything that's growing in the middle, because we're aiming for a vase trimming. That means the middle is open, and so all of these ones that are in the middle have to go. And lastly, we're going to be taking off anything that is over 8 feet tall. We don't want to be on a ladder cutting, picking peaches. We want to be able to get them so that they're producing at a level where we can pick them. And with this rejuvenating cutting that we're doing, it should probably this year we won't be getting any, but the following year should be great. So right now we're going to start with this tree and then we'll move on to the other tree. My tools of choice for today, I'm going to be using these little trimmers for doing the smaller ones. I will be using these loppers, and some of you may notice that that is my new DRAM lopper that the DRAM company sent us. And if there's tiny ones, I might be able to use those little trimmers, but mostly I think it'll be a little bit bigger.
Okay. So we're going to start practicing with this tree first?
We'll practice with this tree. And what we're thinking is, they gave us nothing last year, so whatever we do this year, hopefully it'll be better than last year.
Timber.
Here it all has to come off. This one, because it's in the middle. No, that's good, but you can maybe, no, okay, and then that little piece there has to go, this has to go. Boy, it's hot out here. We're just not used to this hot weather. It's in the 60s, feels like it's in the 90s. Anyway, you can see how drastically we have trimmed this back. Oh, keep in mind, this is a rejuvenating trim so that it's going to start blossoming out. It's going to have more leaves than more branches that are coming out of it and rejuvenating its growth. So first we did the downward sloping branches, then the upward sloping branches, then the ones that were on the inside because we're after this vase shape, and then we chopped off the very tall branches. And you can see there's half the tree right there. But this is what we need. We also wanted to point out that this one year we were about to have a terrible windstorm. In fact, there were tornado warnings out, and about a half a mile away we had great wind shear going on. So we just took reinforcements and attached the trees to poles in the ground just to keep them from being toppled. And it did, but we left them on too long, so that's why we have markings on the trunks. Hopefully that won't inhibit it, and it hasn't seemed to. So we're hoping for a really nice leaf out this spring and peaches next year. Now, you can see in the background, this is our next one right here. This has some major trimming that has to be done also.
Well, the goal is to keep them no higher than 8 feet.
Right, and to keep the center clear. So you can see things like this would have to go. Anything that's going straight up again, that has to go.
Well, anything that's crossing over like this,
yes,
as an example,
this
rubbing.
This is just
right.
Not good.
Yeah.
And this is in the center, this is in the center. So anything going straight up or straight down or in the middle or crossing or dead, out they go. So we have our work cut out for us. This too, you can see where the girdling took place when we had our support up there attached to the metal pole in the ground. Probably,
you know,
saved it though, because otherwise they would have been down on the ground.
Well, a half a mile north of us, 6 blocks north of us, all the big trees were totally toppled.
Right,
I mean, any kind of tree you can think of, that wind shear came in with such force, it just literally tore trees down and put them on top of houses and cars. It was
right.
A huge, huge mess.
And our peach trees already had peaches on them, so we knew there was no hope if that came through and we hadn't done something with them.
That was a very, very busy hour.
That was.
That's about the most time we had to batten down the hatch, so
yes,
to speak.
So we're going to finish the rejuvenation trimming of this one, and then we are going to be going to our newly planted peach trees that we planted last year, which are very tiny at this point, and we want to make sure that their foundation trimming is taking place so that they grow correctly from the beginning this time.
Well, maybe we should just go over there, because I don't think we're going to get them all done today.
No,
if we're trying to,
so
let's
okay,
go do the little ones.
Now here's one of our babies, and again we're after the vase, the open vase kind of shape. And you see that we still have them protected. We don't know if the rabbits are still going to be interested or not. And then I protected the branches from the wire with a pair of old socks. So this one is going in the center too much. I'm going to take, well, this one too, so I'm going to take this one first. And you want to get it close to the tree as possible without going into that collar where it meets the tree. You see that little collar is still on there, and that's good. Okay, and then this one has to come out. Okay, and then anything that's going into the center is coming out. Going into the center, so that's not good. This is going into the center. This one. Okay, this one. Now let's look at the angle of this. Now this is a decision time. Do I want to keep this one, or do I want to keep this one?
I would keep the bigger one and get rid of the little
keep
one.
The bigger.
Yeah. Right. Because you're after a 30 to 45 degree angle. Those are the ones you want to leave.
Right.
Because they're going to be able to handle the weight.
Then we look at this. Which of these? This one obviously want to keep.
Yep.
This one maybe, and this one goodbye.
Yep.
Okay.
Again, you know, once you get these trees under control, then every year you have to go in and make, it's decision time. You know, what
right.
do you keep, what do you get rid of?
And it helps if you have more than one person looking at it, because you may think you have them all and then lo and behold you've missed some. All right, so this one has to come out because that's going to be too far in the center. This one's dead, so that one's coming out.
No, plus it's vertical.
Right. All right, looking around. How high are we going to go here?
Again, no higher than 8 feet, so.
Okay, so maybe top this right here?
Yeah. The vertical one, yep.
Okay, and then while I'm up there, we also found out in our research that you should take off the very tips to keep the producing stems strong so they're not dangly.
How about this one out here too?
Yeah, I can see where the end has died off anyway, so I'm just going to take it there. And I'm chopping right below, or right above where the next bud is. All right, take this little bud here. Okay, how's this looking?
Now, are we going to keep this one here because it's pretty vertical?
This one?
Or are you going to train it to go out horizontally?
Well, I suppose we could. We could put a, they show in the, when you study them and when we've been at different gardening places, they put actual wedges of wood.
Yeah. Well, let's experiment with that one and keep that one.
Okay.
We got to do some trimming on this one here, though.
All right.
And
this little guy going?
Yep. Plus the top is going straight vertical.
True. So, shall I cut it totally off so that these guys go?
Yep.
Maybe down farther, huh?
Yep.
I'm trying to cut it.
You know, sometimes it's good to cut it above where you really want to cut it. That way, if it does give way, especially if it's a heavier branch, it may rip off some of the bark, and you want it as nice, clean cut, 45-degree angle cut or angle cut, so the water can just drain right off of it and keep the cut clean so you don't encourage pests.
Okay, now I'm just taking the little tips off.
Now, is that going to be too many in there? Is the next question. Do you have too many branches too close to each other?
I think I should take... Well, remember when we were looking at our resource, they said have growth about every 2 feet.
Right.
And then in between, there was just open, so...
Well, we could leave it for this year, too, and, you know...
See how they do. True. We can take them off later. Okay, so I think I've got these pretty well trimmed. This one here. What am I doing on this side? So it's falling over. Now they were pretty well trimmed when we bought them. I must say that the nursery that grew them did a very nice job of trimming. So you can see that having fruit trees is delightful when they're producing, but you also have to do something with them. They don't come for free. So if you enjoyed this video and learned something, please give us a thumbs up, and thanks for watching. If you have comments or suggestions for us, please leave a comment, and we'd love to have you join our garden family and be part of our subscribers.
And you're welcome to come over and bring some tools and help us do a lot of trimming. We have a few trees here. How about your willow tree over there?
Yes, that's nice and tall now. It'll be very pretty. Bye for now.
Well, you only have 3 more little peach trees and 1 big peach tree to go.
Mm-hmm.
Connect with us on YouTube.